One thing I like about the TTC is that it makes us all mobile, even if we don't have a car, which I don't, even if we can't walk, which I can. And you see people, you don't have to speak to them, you can, you probably won't. That's the beauty of Bessarion Station. I feel like nobody ever needs to go there, as far as I can tell. Anything I know about Toronto, nothing is just off of Bessarion Station. That means it's a true destination. You have to want to go there. I am going to Bessarion Station to prove to myself that Bessarion Station exists. I believe it exists. I have no direct proof yet. And that way it's like God or truffles. I just need to do this for myself. Bessarion, is it the name of the person who founded it? Is it something from Star Wars? We're really not sure. It could be the name of the street that the station is on. That would be obvious, but I don't feel like Bessarion's gonna be doing anything obvious with us. I don't think that's their style. I don't know what it's like. Are the benches red? Probably. Are there stairs? There's gotta be. I think that's the law. But other than that, I have no idea what I'm going to see there. I consider myself very well versed in the TTC. My experience with the Purple Line is you clench your teeth and bear it until you're at Don Mills Station. And the line itself in between is a real mystery with Bessarion at the top of that list. So my thoughts are people think of the Purple Line as a means to an end, but I'm gonna explore it for its own sake today. To me, I know it only as the Purple Line. Not named after anybody named Purple, it's just on the map. It's the color.
The next station is Bessarion. Bessarion Station.
They just announced it as Bessarion Station. I've been doing a hard S, Bessarion. I'm gonna wait for a sort of second opinion on that before I commit, because it's an important decision.
Arriving at Bessarion, Bessarion Station.
It's so red. It's beautiful. First impression, this is the nicest subway station I have ever been to. Was this built on Friday? What's this? Doesn't do anything. It's purely aesthetic. This is the prettiest. That's so nice. They've got art. Few people will ever see this. You see, nobody's really using this station. This is for purely. Bessarion Station is a home of beautiful things. It's as much an art gallery as it is a train station. We need to discuss this. What is the top two-thirds of this photograph? What is going on? The inside of Bessarion Station gets a 10 out of 10. It is now defined as the Bessarion. I don't think much of this side of Bessarion Station. I think all the gems are inside. We have some parking. I see a Canadian Tire and just a random highway. This is Well, here's something. There are four different newspapers available right outside of Bessarion Station. Three of them are free. That's something. I've been outside of Bessarion Station for about 5 minutes, and I think I've taken in everything there is to take in.
in this area at present, and it's time to get back on the subway. You know, yesterday I had never been to Bessarion. I didn't know the beauties it held, but now, you know what, I've always got it. It's a lovely place to take a girl on a date, and I really can't say where I might go next. I mean, I never thought I'd be at Bessarion, but here I am. What's next? Runnymede? Paris? Kipling? The possibilities are endless. Don't be afraid to journey, my friends. Don't be afraid to discover your own personal purple line. Everyone has their own Bessarion.
How it makes me quiver. How it makes me smile. With all this love I have to give you.